it or dented.
No dents whatsoever.
Mm. Nice. Chrome, not the bumpers on that.
Good.
Yeah.
Very good condition.
Yeah. A nice 61 Cadillac limousine there. Nice old car. That'd go down well in England.
The engine runs really good.
Yeah. Nice condition. Look like this back wing was a little bit wavy on it.
Yeah,
nice looking Hudson. It's absolutely in first class order. I was saying it's quite nice, but sort of a bit, you know.
Yeah, I'm really looking for a Roadmaster two-door hardtop.
Yeah, it's an old Buick. That one looked like it needed plenty of work.
What colour is that?
Pink.
Yeah, and is the paint good on it?
It's old, you know. No,
it's not good. I mean, if you stand 15 feet away, it looks good. This is the Pomona Swap Meet, a regular open-air market for California's car fraternity. Here in the land of the endless highway, of drive-in everything, the car is still an icon of optimism that nothing can diminish. Stuart and Milton Holman are from Battersea, South London. Their company, Dream Cars, specializes in 50s American automobiles. Every 6 weeks, they come to California looking for new stock.
Nice color.
It's got a traffic light viewer in it.
Is it?
Innovations like a traffic light viewer on this 1959 Ford Skyliner are part of the B-movie science fiction appeal of 50s American cars.
Tinted windows. Well, these mirrors, they're really rare on these factory fender skirts. Yeah, the sill trim's been screwed on, that's a shame. It's a bit iffy.
A peach Skyliner might look neat cruising down the King's Road, Chelsea, but so might a 1956 Chrysler Imperial.
Is it 55 or 56? It's amazing. It's got like flush door handles.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Anti burst doors.
Air conditioning. Yeah. Look at that. Intakes. Nice. Wire wheels. You have to sell that easily if you got it to England.
Firm in red.
Yeah, but it
still looks
nice like that.
Stuart and Milton have come to Los Angeles with a shopping list of specific cars for specific buyers. Over the years, they have made valuable contacts with Californian dealers and enthusiasts who can make their London customers' dreams come true. For a small fee, Ed Berry thinks he can put the boys in contact with a mint 53 Cadillac convertible.
So what you need to do is take a look at it and see what's there and see if it really fits. Yeah. You know, he did the rubber on it, did the paint, did the leather, did the chrome.
Yeah, what I'd like to do is come down and look at it, and maybe tomorrow or Tuesday.
Yeah, well, there's a car out there with your name on it sometimes.
Yeah. Excuse me. Are you selling this?
A 1948 Buick Roadmaster has been on the shopping list for almost a year.
Right.
The car is in need of restoration but is completely rust free.
Well, the chassis number and that's all right on, isn't it? You know, on the same one that's on the logbook.
Once the famous pink slip is signed, the Roadmaster is on its way back to London.
We're in this quite a lucky position that we're able to earn a living out of it by doing what we enjoy, so you don't, you know, you sort of don't feel as if you're going to work. It has grown out as a hobby of collecting the cars and then being asked more and more, you know, can you get me, you know, particular cars, and it just really grew out of that. Well, we come to California because the condition of cars out here is so good because of the climate. This really is the place where you find the best examples. We've got this for somebody. You know, it's a guy who's got quite a big collection of cars and he wants to add some 50s American cars to that collection. And the brief that we got was, you know, he gave us a list of a half a dozen cars that he wanted in good, clean, rust-free, running condition, but that needed restoring. There's definitely easier ways of earning a living. I don't know whether there'd be more enjoyable ways of earning a living. You know, you've got to know what you're doing and what you're talking about. You know, I mean, a lot of people, you know, they see the cars that we've got at work and they think, oh yeah, I can, you know, go out to America and, you know, find a car on every street corner and, you know, get them for nothing and bring them back and sell them, you know, sort of for a few £1,000. I mean, it just doesn't happen like that.
In fact, finding a car that is both in good condition and will sell back in Battersea is more difficult than it might seem. The next day, Milton and Stuart drive 100 miles out to the San Marino Valley to visit Fred Van Horn, who they bought the 48 Buick Roadmaster from at Pomona. Fred has a collection of cars, including a promising-sounding 1956 Cadillac Coupe de Ville, the perfect car for cruising the King's Road on a balmy summer's evening.
Pretty good shape.
Well, I mean, there's nothing like it in England, you know, so yeah.
After years of looking at cars, good and bad, Milton and Stuart can tell immediately whether or not the Coupe de Ville is worth shipping home.
No, it's a straight car. The front end chrome is all really straight, and as it came from the factory, so that would be no problem at all to get it re-chromed and looking good. The plastic insert on the badge needs replacing, but you can buy those reproductions, so that would be no problem.
It is a nice car, and it's rust-free, which is the main thing that we look for. But then, having said that, you know, if you saw it down the road, sort of 20 feet away, it would look good, but when you actually get up and look around it, like, the doors don't really shut that nicely. They're shut, but they're just not clean the way they're shut. By the time it's back in England, and, you know, we sort of do the work that it needs doing to it, it's just going to make it too expensive to sell to somebody.
As with many 50s American cars, the Coupe de Ville owes its style to one man, Harley Earl. It was Earl who ruled General Motors' colour and styling studio for almost 30 years, and single-handedly invented the fins and chrome of the classic 50s American car. Taking his influences from warplanes and Hollywood science fiction, Earl's studio created cars that reflected America's status as the most powerful nation on Earth, and even the universe. 40 years later, Earl's extravagant designs are still in demand. With much of the day spent cruising California's highways searching for cars, in the evenings, Milton and Stuart clock up a massive telephone bill, following up leads from the Los Angeles second-hand magazines.
I've got $800 just to break them off. Mm-hmm. We'll break it up when we read them.
What are you asking for that?
Got it in there for $2,750.
This man has another Cadillac, but it's a less saleable four-door, not a two-door coupe.
And the 57 two-door has got a lower roof than a four-door, hasn't it? Like, the front windshield is lower, so they just look nicer, you know, with the... And if you've got the windows down and the, you know, the sort of, as it's cruising along, it looks nicer.
I really would rather sort of buy a two-door coupe, but let me give it some thought and I'll have a chat with my brother about it. And what I'll do is, if I'm interested, I'll come and have a look at it.
Thanks a lot.
All right.
Cheers. Bye.
A 57 Cadillac has the instant charisma of a classic car. But in 30 years' time, Milton and Stuart might be cruising LA in search of a Ford Thunderbird like the one they have hired.
You know, these particular Thunderbirds, which are the top-of-the-line super coupe, will certainly become a classic in 20 or 30 years. Obviously, as long as we've still got fossil fuels, we'll all be driving around in them and collecting them. But, you know, no one knows what would happen if we had to go over to using solar power. These would obviously become the dinosaurs.
Yeah, and this is a retractable. Yeah, it looks really nice.
One of the dinosaurs of the late 1950s is the Ford Skyliner Retractable. It won't be for sale in the Battersea showroom. This car is for Stuart's personal use. This particular car belonged to a 70-year-old woman who had recently divorced. Its one-owner history and complete service record make it the find of a lifetime.
That's virtually perfect, that. If you re-chrome that, I mean, you'd probably get it to shine a bit, but it never looked, and the car just looks so original.
The retractable's roof is a real triumph of available technology over practicality. It utilises no less than 7 reversible electric motors, 23 switches, 9 circuit breakers, and 600 feet of wire.
Oh, baby, baby.
The 59 Retractable, my favourite American car. There's something about them. I mean, I know that there's other cars that are sort of better looking cars than the Retractable, but it's just the Retractable is the one that I like the best out of all of them, you know. I like the style of it, I like the way the top works. Watch it working, I mean, it's a work of art. It isn't a really practical car because, you know, with the top down, the amount of usable boot space you've got is probably smaller than that of a Mini. But that isn't the reason I'm buying it. You know, I'm buying it because I like it so much.
Frisco's Wednesday night car show is a real slice of American road culture. It's another opportunity for Stuart and Milton to make